being here tonight, and a big thanks to the Western Community Coalition for organizing tonight's debate.
I think a lot has been accomplished with the Liberal government.
In 2003, Dalton McGuinty made you a series of promises, and you placed your trust in him.
The McGuinty government has made progress, but there's still a lot more to be done.
Since that time, Dalton McGuinty has repeatedly lied to you and betrayed your trust.
For the Green Party, it is not only an environmental party, but it has the same objectives as any other party.
The results of this by-election will not change the government.
I'm committed to ensuring that all students, regardless of background, have the opportunity and the tools to succeed.
The government will still be the same on February the 9th, whether we like it or not.
Dalton McGuinty signed a pledge that he wouldn't raise your taxes. Instead, he introduced the largest single tax increase in Ontario's history.
I also believe that we are much better off than we were 4 years ago.
Send a message to the Premier, Dalton McGuinty, that York Southwestern deserves better.
I am dedicated to improving our schools, including more money for buildings.
Prosperity, healthcare, childcare, crime control.
Dalton McGuinty has ignored the needs of this community.
I have come to know and appreciate the diversity of the residents of York Southwest.
You know me as someone who gets things done.
Boasting resources and a healthy environment.
I will fight for this community. I will fight for you.
Dalton McGuinty is a bad role model for our children.
The minimum wage should be raised to $10 an hour.
I've also been there to help people like Ms. Mullins on Weston Road, who was facing eviction from her apartment. I worked to ensure that she was able to find a good, affordable place to live.
I would like to be your champion at Queen's Park.
Ask yourself, are you getting better value for your tax dollar under the McGuinty Liberal government?
Or helping Mr. Greck on McDonald Avenue get his tree trimmed?
I'm also opposed to Blue 22.
It's the big things, it's the little things, it's things that I'm proud to have accomplished on your behalf.
And the question for you is, did Dalton McGuinty pass or did Dalton McGuinty fail?
Mr. McGuinty and his government, in an extended sitting of the legislature, ran through a 31% pay hike for themselves.
Shame. I was about to say you had two choices, because Paul Ferriero stand up for you, and I will stand up for you. But Mr. Ferriero put himself out of the race when he glorified himself for the things he did for people in this riding. Can you imagine those people that he helped trim your tree or farm a place? Imagine how they would feel if they were here, having them be stand out as someone who was blessed by Mr. Ferriero and in turn to glorify himself.
Now, we're talking about Ms. Martino. Ms. Martino is telling you about Dalton McGuinty and his Liberals, but she's not telling you about what she will do. What will you do? Kevin Clarke spoke out loud. Look at the amount of law enforcement officers that are here tonight. They're here tonight because Kevin Clarke is here. So what does that tell you? That tells you that Kevin Clarke has a voice. The fact that I was a homeless man, the fact that I'm an ex-con, ex-drug dealer, ex-pimp, ex-crackhead, and I am the most arrested man in the history of the city of Toronto for speaking out loud. I am also the most successful public defender, 61 wins, 2 losses in a court of law, standing up to the truth. I was brought up in Jane and Tithoui by my mother, who brought me here as a single mother. We moved to Scarborough, we moved all across the city, and God bless the single mothers, and as your candidate, and as your member of provincial parliament, I will stand up not only for the single mothers, I will stand up for the mothers, the fathers, the brothers, the sisters, the uncles, the cousins, the nieces, the nephews, your enemies, your friends. I will bring them together as one, and we will end the violence. We will feed the hungry. We will oust the homeless. We will stop the abuse of authority. Teach the children love, acceptance, and forgiveness. And I will take the police out of this debate. And I will have them in the schools from 8 a.m. till 10 a.m. when the kids go to school, to discourage those who will bring guns, knives, or their bullying attitudes to the schools. And we will change. change the path of our government so they serve you. And last but not least, you will receive a 25% raise increase if the government does not repel their 25% raise. Then all province, all people in Ontario are entitled to a 25% raise.